6 months ago, I was a group president of Caterpillar and in line to compete to be a future CEO of the company until November 5th when I got the words, you have ALS.
Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, it's a disease of motor neurons. So essentially the cells of your body that control movement are the cells that are targeted by this disease.
What happens is a breakdown in those motor neurons and they start to die, and it affects the voluntary muscles, the movements. It starts with arms, moves to legs. It finishes with, if you would, your diaphragm, your breathing, which is what eventually kills. But if you fall in the average category, you have a lifespan of 3 to 5 years from diagnosis. So it went from being, a bucket challenge, something I was aware of through friends that were impacted, to something personal.
ALS is very difficult to cure for many different reasons. Probably the foremost among them is that we don't know for the majority of cases what is actually causing the disease. Because it's rare, it's also been hard, I think, to design clinical trials to test drugs. So we can't treat it because we don't have medicine that can actually stop the neurons from dying.
The ultimate, definition of winning in the world of ALS is a cure. The reality of it is, there may be dominoes we need to knock down well in advance of eventually finding the cure, that if we could unlock that key, that we could open up, new pathways in terms of research, development, and some other things. And I think that's what the process is going to force us through. How do we identify what are those key roadblocks today that are not enabling progress to be made? And then how do we turn that into a prize to maybe knock down a domino that sets us on a path to finally cure this thing once and for all? As I engage in this fight, it's for not only the people in my situation, but it's for the assembly line worker, the UPS driver, the person in a local grocery store who gets this disease but doesn't have the access to the resources, doesn't have relationships with an organization like XPRIZE, that they can really try to make a difference. And so, as one of my colleagues who has the disease said, when you get the diagnosis, you got a choice. You can stay in bed or you can stay engaged. And I've opted to stay engaged.